Hi, I'm Cowboy Keith, filmmaker. Maybe you've seen that commercial with the little dog that chases the chuck wagon under the sinks. That wasn't me. That was Marty DeBurgi. But I made a documentary film about a professional whistler. Why I captured the sights, the sounds, the halitosis of a professional whistler. A documentary, a whistlementary, if you will. So, come with me. Let's take a peek into the world of a professional whistler.
My name is Bill Davis, and I'm a professional whistler. I've been whistling my whole life. I believe Del Shannon's Runaway was the first time I ever whistled. I whistled the Farfisa organ solo, much to the surprise of my family, who hadn't heard me speak yet. So I have a gift. My first professional whistling endeavor, I think I was 6 or 7, and my parents took me to a bird whistling convention where there was a competition. And despite being the only human who was taking part, I won. The birds were, needless to say, disappointed. You could tell but they were singing sadder after I left, but I was not. In middle school, I think not only did I discover more ways to whistle, but I discovered girls. And when you discover girls and more ways to whistle, you learn that one whistle that I'm sure every woman has heard. You know what I'm talking about. Jim Carrey. In high school, I had a part-time job bagging groceries at the local Piggly Wiggly, and I was whistling one of my favorite Andy Williams tunes, and a gentleman said, "Who's whistling? Who's whistling?" And I could hear him. He came and he sought me out, and he said, "Are you the one I heard whistling?" And I said, "Yeah." And he said, "Cut it out! I hate Moon River." And that's when I knew I had something. Well, it wasn't long before I outgrew my small town. Felt like I needed to see what else was out there. So I packed my bag and filled it up full of chapstick and banaca, and I brought my mustache comb and I took it with me to New York City. That's when things got really weird. I'll never forget, I was whistling in the subway, which if you're gonna do it, you might as well just stop when the trains go by. But I was whistling in the subway, and people really liked me. They were throwing coins at me. I guess, you know, when you have a guitar, they throw it in your case, and when that music comes out of your mouth, they think your mouth's the case, because that's where they were aiming. But I don't care if their aim is bad, because they knew that I was worth investing in. But nevertheless, I'll never forget, Andy Rooney says, "I really like the sound of your whistling." And I just didn't even know he liked anything. Oh! I haven't had this mustache my entire career. As my whistling got louder, I felt the need to dampen it with a mustache.
Plus the ladies like it.
Oh, hi, how are you? I didn't see you there. I was just whistling the music from Super Mario 2. I'm here in the studio, and I'd like to talk to you a little bit about technique. I've mastered inward, outward, humming, sideways whistling, dual whistling sideways. I don't do that very often, and I charge a lot for it. I was invited by the symphony to join them at Carnegie Hall. Not the New York Symphony, but the New Rochelle Symphony was playing in the lobby as people came in. And we were doing Rhapsody in Blue. And who walks in but Gene Hackman? Next thing you know, I'm working for United Airlines. No, absolutely not. I won't let anyone auto-tune me. I walked off a Rascal Flatts gig over that. I have standards. One time somebody asked me to whistle Dixie. I'm not kidding, they did. I said no. See this? I don't need this. That's a pop filter, and they're for amateurs. I whistle in. So when you pay a little extra to get me, you make up for it in savings because you don't have to rent pop filters. My mustache is bothering me. I had a little bit of exposure in Europe. A lot of people think that's me with the scorpions. It's not. I almost had the gig. I speak German, but I can't whistle German.
Whippoorwill. Are those crickets?
In the 90s, they tried to do another reboot of Lassie, with the original cast, and they asked me to come in and redo the theme song. Unfortunately, the dog was very elderly and it didn't make it past the test markets. You have to develop a lot of force in and out. So whenever I'm drinking something, I suck the fluid out of the bottle. Carrots, popsicles, bananas, anything I can put in and out of my mouth. Popsicles are nice because if I eat red ones, my lips are a nice tone. I do a lot of soundtrack work, video games, etc. And I actually got a little bit of grief from Michael Winslow. The man can do sirens, he can do Hendrix, but he can't whistle. Sorry, Michael. We all know that one, right? I didn't do that gig. That was an Italian fellow. However, I once studied under the same whistling coach that he studied under, and that whistling coach told me he couldn't tell the difference between us when his eyes were closed, and I think that's why so many people think I did that part. A lot of people don't realize whistling is genderless. I can whistle male parts. I can whistle female parts. I can whistle transgendered parts. Madonna. Or, Cindy Lauper. Also female. Boy George. Transgendered. That's me whistling on We Are the World. Yeah, it got buried in the mix a little bit, but I can hear it. Fun fact, I took that photo, that's why I'm not in it. You know when you're in an elevator or at the dentist's office, they want you to hear popular music, but they don't want you to connect with it and get distracted and feel anything. And that's where I come in. They call whistlers for jobs like those. When you're in an elevator and you hear Stairway to Heaven, it might be me, or you might really be on a stairway to heaven. Fun fact, Dirty Dancing, right before the big kiss, the big one, a little bird outside makes a little noise. It's not a bird at all, folks. Uncredited. Some people whistle when they work. I work while I whistle.